you seem determined to resist your inevitable fate, I will extinguish your last glimmer of hope.
Sit down and a cup of tea. not somebody gives me a real challenge.
My dear Desdemona, what a surprise to see you. By my reckoning, you and your companion should be long dead.
Ha! You obviously don't know who you're dealing with, and you'll find my friends here are no pushovers either.
That's right, Pops. You made a big mistake when you messed with us.
I shall be certain to correct my error. I do so detest you, Zed.
Your Radiance! You're the supreme sovereign of the Seven Realms, the one who's supposed to keep the peace in our world! So why? Why would you do this?
Why, you ask? To keep the very peace you hold so dear, of course.
What, by invading Tunisia? You send monsters to kill my people, and you call that keeping the peace?
Allow us to explain, my young friend. In order to rid the world of war, one must eliminate the source of conflict. Which is to say, of course, the species known as humankind.
Huh? Nonsense! Humans don't cause conflict. Ever since the War of Kings, we've heeded the word of the prophecy and kept the peace for 1,000 years. How can you possibly say that we're to blame?
Behold!
Could this be your fabled cup of kings?
It is brimming with evil.
The cup overfloweth! With man's doubt for his fellow man, with his hatred, with his violence, yea, his every negative urge, it is wholly corrupted by darkness. This once hallowed chalice now spills over with spite and despair. Proof, if any were needed, of humanity's irredeemable depravity. You were warned. You heard the prophecy and rushed headlong into war regardless. In doing so, you revealed your true nature and proved yourselves beyond salvation. That is why, as the chosen twins of prophecy, we came to our decision to purge this land of its human blight and create a new world free of conflict.
Marcus, do you honestly expect us to accept this?
You believe because you are twins, this makes you doubly correct? Foolish men, you are quadruply false!
All has come to pass just as the prophecy foretold. The earth has been bathed in blood, and we have duly taken our place as the world's true ruler. Our reign is preordained. Our will shall not be disobeyed. We hereby decree that humankind in its entirety must be exterminated once and for all.
Look, I think they're absorbing the darkness from the Cup of Kings.
Guess these guys are in business. Luckily, we need business too.
Whatever the prophecy says is going to happen, I don't care. It doesn't mean we can't fight it.
We're going to beat you and save our world. You can stick your prophecy where the sun don't shine.
If you wish to fight destiny itself, you are welcome to try. We shall be more than happy to seal your fate.
Just don't
succumb to my
runs on blood and flesh. It is too much sinful.
Oh, ha, ha, ha. My own flesh and blood. My only brother died a long time ago. Over 1,000 years, in fact.
1,000 years? What nonsense is this?
Twin brother.
Since I'm in such a good mood, I will grant you the explanation you so fervently desire. I borrowed this old fool's form with one thing in mind. To corrupt the purpose of your precious prophecy. To what end? By cruising as your pathetic rulers, twin brother, I gained access to the highest office in the Seven Realms. Thus, I corrupt the Cup of Kings and convince him to destroy his own people.
Are you saying this is all you're doing?
Precisely. And it was all so easy. In his heart of hearts, your High King was an unusually fit listening creature. I had but to coax out his true nature. He was a very willing pawn in my game, but one which has served its purpose. The Seven Realms have been plunged into chaos, and the Cup of Kings overflows through the darkness of men's hearts. All is as it was 1,000 years ago. I have only to use the power of the Cup of Kings to awaken my true strength, and I shall become a being more terrible than the very gods themselves!
single way.
I only wish there were. Well, you know what would happen if anyone learned the truth? Even if we kept them locked away, he'd be sure to find them sooner or later. And that means hard. We have to split them up.
All right. If you promise me we'll keep them safe. Desdemona! Oh, thank goodness, you're okay.
You don't deserve to live, and we won't let you.
Yeah, you never should have been born. We'll take you down for the sake of this world.
I never should have been born. What are you talking about? I don't understand. A war, then make one in hell.
Yes, there is no place for you here. This world does not need you.
The world doesn't need me. Is all this war because of me?
Loathsome, disgusting, wretched, you are most contemptible vermin.
We will return you to the other side, war-mongering villains.
This is ridiculous! I didn't start any war!
You. Your very existence robbed me of a father. You will pay. With your life!
Cesar! Not you too. Please, you've got to come back to your senses. people I care about.
Exactly happened to us back there. Fractals hit us with the lightning, and then...
Sorry, Dad. Well, that's as much as any of us remembers. Woke up down here with no pinnacle of peace left.
Guess someone was looking out for us, huh? Got us out of there before the whole place came crumbling down. Don't know who, though.
There's one thing we do remember, right, everyone?
The truth is, while we were unconscious, it seems we all had the same dream.
A dream? It was about you.